Hello everyone, Gliderman here. So welcome to episode 2 of this LeJOS EV3 tutorial series. And today we're going to be learning how to make our robot drive forward. So we're going to start out with something pretty simple with that. So we're going to just delete this. This is a comment that it automatically generates. Just hit delete on that. And in this section here, what we're going to do is we're going to type motor with a capital M, and then we're going to press period, or what I'm going to probably refer to this a lot as dot. And then you can see that we've got a list of all of these motors. I don't know why it's called them NXT motors, but they're the motors that will be controlled by the EV3. And so these are going to be the left and right motors of whatever robot that you built. It could be like even like the sample project or sample build or whatever. And so I'm just going to say it's going to be motor A as my left one. You can see here it did a little bit of auto completion and added an import statement here so that it can control the motor. And then we're going to jump back down here and we're going to say another dot, and then we're going to see this one here, which is forward. You can also start typing in a little bit here, and you can see that it starts to autocomplete to there. Just press enter there, and now the motor in the A port will drive forward. Now we're going to hit enter or return, depending on your keyword, and we're going to type basically the same thing, but we're going to have B so that it's going to be the motor in the B port. And then same thing with forward. And now what we're going to do is we're going to delay so that the motors actually have a chance to spin before the program exits. So we're going to call the delay class. So they're just like the motor class, we're going to have a capital D in delay. And then we're going to type dot or period. And then you can see down here we've got a millisecond delay or MS delay. There's also nanosecond and microsecond. But those are even smaller time intervals. So we're going to do that. Press enter. You can see it also imported the delay class. And then we're going to say 2000. So what a millisecond is 1/1000th of a second. So to delay for 2 seconds, we need to delay for 2,000 milliseconds. And then that'll say, okay, put those two motors going forward, delay for 2 seconds, and then what we want to do is we want to stop the motors. So we're going to do motor.A, and then we're going to call stop. And then we're going to do the same thing for motor.B. And then we're going to call stop on that. Now, what you would do is you would click the run button here, or you can use the one that's up here. This menu system will give you a little drop down to select the run, or you can go to this little one. It almost looks like a play button. And you want to click the drop down, and then run as, and you want to run it as a LeJOS EV3 program. So you just click that. It's going to ask you to save it. If you just didn't save, it's Control S on Windows and Command S on Mac. And then we're going to click OK. And then it will be launching it. So now it brings up the console here. You can see it's created the jar file, which will run on the EV3 successfully. And then using the EV3 uploading, and I just don't have an EV3 plugged in, and that's why it doesn't show that it's uploaded. But with your actual EV3 that's plugged in and booted into the LeJOS, it will then drive both motor A and motor B forward, delay for 2 seconds, and then stop it. So that was episode 2, and thanks for watching. Bye!